You're empty. And Jesus wants to pour into them.
Yeah.
Jesus wants to pour into them. I just say what he's pouring into my life. Just say he's got the grace of God that I'm able to stay here.
Come on.
And I'm not preaching this to you because I love y'all. I know two people, this is my first time doing it. But it's only by the Holy Spirit that I'm able to stay here. And because I love his people, I love y'all so much. I know a lot of people ain't heard that before. Y'all don't know me, you don't know me. And I don't know you, but I love you. I love you. How you feel my passion is because I love you, because I love you so much more.
Yeah,
that's it. He loves you so much more.
Yeah. Come on.
So please, I'm begging on behalf of God. Choose, Jesus, choose life. You're walking around like a bag of bones right now. You're hurting. You have your smile on your face, but you're hurting. You know what your thoughts are, you're crying on your face. But when are you going to stand alone? When are you going to stand alone? Do you know who you are? Do you truly know who you are? Because God tells you that the spirit in you is like true man. And God tells you that I have created you to not only know you, but to make you known to everyone. So that's what we're doing. I don't want this of the tree, or the car, or the building, to pass that place that I do. Because even the Lord shout out the place, because they know how great the name of Jesus is. And they shall shout crazy. And they shall crazy to the people that don't know Jesus Christ. We may shout crazy. And that's what I used to do. Y'all are crazy. What are you talking about? What is this man that hung on the cross for me? What does that have to do with me? Until I realized his death is Jesus. And he hung on the cross and had nails in his hands and nails in his feet. And he was whipped and he was beaten and he was bruised. But not me for you, for everybody who is God so loved the world. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, his only Son, Jesus Christ. So those who do not believe in him shall not perish, like those that do not believe, but they'll have eternal life. So choose him. There's nothing that you've done that has put in you too far from God. It's only by God's grace and God's mercy that we even are able to wake up. And some people say, I may wake up tomorrow. I still want to do this before I give my life to Christ. But guess what? Tomorrow is not promised. 5 minutes from now is not promised. It's not promised. Nothing is promised. Everything that's promised in this world is death. Everyone will die. But no man, no time, no leave this earth. And are you going to go to heaven with Jesus Christ and have eternal life with him? Are you going to go to hell because you have so much fun on earth, something that everyone has been receiving, and spend that eternity with hell, with Satan? The only thing promised is death. You don't even know what tomorrow is going to look like for you. You don't know if you have tomorrow. Give your life to Jesus now. You don't have to put that blanket on first to come to Jesus Christ. because he wants you.
That's it. Pull
in there.
Survival.
And people in the country have to say, come as you are. And that's true. Come as you are. Because I'm going as you are. Because Jesus got everywhere in this
creation.
You're a new Christian, Christ. You're a new Christian, Christ.
A new covenant.
So come to him. Tomorrow is not promised. The only thing that's promised is death. So there are promises. I understand. Jesus was the last to dare him. He was the last to dare because nothing else is worth it. Do you know how it feels to tell everything you think is everything? And that still not worth a thing of therapy? Well, therapists are not about me. You know who will never forget about me? Jesus Christ.
Satan wants you to be deceived.
I tried that man. I've tried everything. There's nothing that this man that can keep you from Jesus. Jesus loves you. God loves you. The God of peace, the God that created you, will not let you play because you must be with him. God loves you. And he doesn't want anyone to pray. You are not yourself to pray. Because you do not see Jesus Christ. None of these other trees, I don't care who you are. I don't care who you serve.
They don't like
you,
but
they do not have any cross for you. They are not still mad for you. You can go see them for fun.
Italia.
Yes, I can't come. I can't be. Having God for you, how are you going to have eternal life? There are God at the door. A God at the door.
A man can't
worship
the Father.
The only God that's still alive, sitting at the right hand of God the Father, is Jesus Christ. And the Holy Spirit is still in the Holy Spirit right now. I am in the presence of the Holy Spirit in the
nation.
I am in the presence of the nation of God. I am in the presence that you can live right now in this life. And then Jesus brings you up. Yes, oh, it's free. Jesus told me, it's not by law, by Jesus, man.
Yes.
It's not by law that I see this man that I see. It's not by the law that Jesus Christ.
I got
you. That's the only way I see. That's the only way I'm able to see what I see now. That's the only way, because of the mercy of God.
This
is
more than money.
So I love you so much, and that's why I'm here, that's why we are here, telling you about the Lord Jesus Christ, and yet he does love you, and he hung on that cross for you, and he was speechless. He had nails in his hands, he had nails in his feet, he was real. And I know I was going to live with those guys, because I had a lot of them in my childhood. And that story made me right.
Tell us.
But Jesus was real. He was bloody and he was clean.
I see it all, yeah. For no reason, yeah.
Family.
I can hear you on my tent.
Family. For your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren. But you know that goodness you're living in? What does it? He's going to pass down from generation to generation until you make the decision.
Yeah.
God is standing in Jesus Christ. Because it's not me and my house, we're going to stand for the Lord.